Welcome, everyone. It is a great and emotional for me privilege to have this choir here tonight. I have some notes that I need to remember, so I have my phone open, but I wanted to mention that when I graduated from Concordia University, Chicago, I was 24 years old, and I had met Dr. Brown one-on-one when I was 12. And I sang in his choir for 6 years, which means that when I graduated, I knew him for half of my life, and I had sang with him for a quarter of it. And you have people in your life that change who you are for the better and develop who you are as a person. And Dr. Brown is one of those people. And he does that year in and year out with these choirs. And so now I get to the notes. This is the boring part. It's actually, none of it's going to be boring, because this is going to be a wonderful night. I'm going to have a lot of fun actually just relaxing and listening to this and reliving some memories and making some new ones with you. So number one is make sure you welcome everyone. One thing we do want to point out is that in the middle of the program, there is what we call an intermission, but for the first part of the intermission, we'll call this pre-intermission, there's going to be a presentation briefly by one of the students, and also the campus pastor has come with the tour, Pastor Jeff Leininger, and he's going to also speak a little bit about the experience at Concordia University, Chicago. And so please stay seated for the first part of the intermission, but don't worry, because the second part, the real intermission, there'll be plenty of time to get up, move around, use the restroom, get drinks of water, etc. And then also at intermission and at the end of the concert, there is a basket in the foyer, and in that, or next to that basket, there are envelopes that say Capella, and that is where this choir greatly appreciates, and the university greatly appreciates your donations, your free will offerings, so that as you leave, and if you want to support the mission and the quality of education that this university produces, then please give a donation that way. Also, in your program, there's a QR code if you are savvy enough. I don't know how to use that, but I think you take out your camera and you hold it over a squiggly barcode-y square thingy, and then it'll open a web page. And if you would like to give that way, you may as well. I'd like to also mention there were a lot of people working behind the scenes to get this set up tonight. And so I'd like everyone to give a nice warm thank you to everyone who provided the food, who provided the tables and all of the background, the advertisement and emailing the radio shows and everything like that. So please give them a nice warm thank you. Please join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for music. Thank you for the gift of the ministry of music and for the way that music can spread your gospel to all corners of the world in a way that we get to not just hear but also experience, and that we can hear in multiple languages, all of the tongues of the earth, that the world is praising you, God, for what you have done. We ask you to bless us now so that we glorify you with our listening and that the choir glorifies you in their singing. In Jesus' name, amen. And now, please welcome Dr. Charles Brown and the Capella of Concordia University, Chicago.
Good evening. What a joy to be here with you at Trinity Apostle Robles. I'm so excited. The last time I was here was 2009. It's great to be back. And we're just very grateful to be here. Just a quick recap. If you want to see the back cover of our program, where we've been, where we're headed, we started in Seattle last Friday as we began our spring break. And we then put on our snowshoes. It was miraculous, actually, getting to Redding. We weren't sure how it was going to be. And it was almost like to the gnat's eyelash with our timing. And thanks be to God, we saw storms over there in the mountains at Mount Shasta, storms over there, clear path. It was really a blessing. So we were overwhelmed at how many people were praying for us on our way. It was really, really, truly special. We're just delighted to be sharing this message with you. And the theme is mercy. In mercy, Lord. We are definitely in need of mercy every day. The text Kyrie eleison, Greek, that's gonna show up in various forms throughout the program. In fact, you're gonna get an opportunity to sing it with us. Don't worry, I give you the Pimsleur tutorial. We'll be set to go. And it's just a wonderful exploration, many different music styles that we're going to explore, and how God has been merciful to us through his son, Christ. And so we are celebrating that. But before I do that, it was so much fun to be here today on campus. Again, we gave an assembly to the kids in the school. We took a little tour of the Steinbeck Winery. We had a lot of fun, and then all of a sudden, we had an awesome dinner, and then all of a sudden, we're just charged up and ready to go for our concert. So we're really excited, and we're going to start with the next piece by Johann Sebastian Bach, and it is Du Hirt Israel. So if you're not sure about German, if it doesn't come to you naturally to translate as you're listening to it, we have translations printed for you in the program booklet. And so this text is really about how he redeems, how God protects his redeemed, his beloved Israel. And the mercy is a form of protection.
Thank you.
we have a number of reasons to celebrate at Concordia, and I have 100 reasons why. Maybe you've been blinded by our jewelry. But actually, so we've been looking through some historical documents, and we think it's been 100 years since concert choral music has happened at Concordia. Obviously, there was choral music and church and worship ever since we started in 1864 in Addison. Any alumni from Addison? It opened in 1864, so I don't think so. We moved to River Forest in 1913, so I figured that was a safe question. But in 1923, concertizing, and the first tour was actually in 1928, and we're considering doing a reenactment of that tour, a Steamboat Clipper across Lake Michigan, and to see how that works. So we'll see. It should be pretty invigorating in March. So how times have changed in terms of travel. So we're very, very grateful for this time to travel on tour and actually to be on a normal tour the first time in 3 years. So we're just very, very overjoyed. So just to be together and to share music in the same space is a real blessing and a privilege. So 100 years of all that, it's just a great, great tradition to carry on. And we also have another anniversary, the 100th anniversary of the birth of Richard Hillert. If you have sung This Is the Feast, you know Richard Hillert, but there is so much more. Service music, organ, handbells, instrumental material, solo voice, choral anthems, you name it, he's done it. It is just staggering what he had done in his career as a composer at Concordia. In Concordia, Chicago, also in River Forest. And so we're going to feature one of his motets that's one of near and dear to my heart, which is from the text from Isaiah, "Surely he has borne our griefs."
Show.
It's a pretty powerful work, isn't it? Heinrich Schütz, who lived 100 years before Johann Sebastian Bach, he composed the St. Matthew Passion, and sometimes they would take material from pre-existing music. For example, that's a hymn that Schütz took, and text that was, we actually don't know who the author is, but it's in context of the Passion here, what Christ has done for us, his atoning sacrifice. So that you saw the surely has borne our griefs, the Old Testament prophecy to the New Testament prophecy, and just very expressive. You think that's such ancient music, but you can even hear how romantic and expressive it is, and it's fun when they actually are. How the students just really responded to that. It's very beautiful music that just deserves to be continued. And so we're really fortunate to be able to sing this. So now we're going to go back to the more modern times, and we're going to take a little trip to Latvia. Richards Dubra. I was introduced to his music 20 years ago on an international tour. Changed my life. And you think about how composition and how music influences people, especially under the heavy hand of communism. And so where Richards Dubra was able to express his faith through music, here we have Psalm 23, directly from the Hebrew into Latin with a Baltic flavor.
Thank you. great. Sorry, I'm bad at technology. I know you don't hear that a lot from 22-year-olds, but that's me. Thank you all for coming out tonight. I hope everyone's doing well. My name is Sarah Teig. I'm a soprano, if you want to look at my picture and information in your book. I am a senior music education student at Concordia Chicago. This is my first time doing this by myself, so I'm a little nervous. thank you. So I get to talk to you a little bit during intermission about what makes Capella so great. So my life story, in a nutshell, is music and Christ. Those have always been the most important things in my life. If I wasn't at church or school, I was in my piano lesson. And Capella is an amazing opportunity to get to do both of those at the same time, to spread the good news of Christ with a whole bunch of people all over the United States and sometimes the world while singing. It's really amazing. Sorry, I don't do this for myself. Am I missing anything? Okay. So, it's a really amazing opportunity to get to come to churches like this and see real people and sing for real people. There was a while there where Capella sang to an empty room because of COVID. And they were live streamed so people could watch them, but we couldn't see all of your smiling faces, which are making me very nervous right now. and I have the joy of introducing you tonight to our president, Dr. Dawn. So he's going to take over from here, and I'm going to go get some water.
You did wonderfully. Actually, I'm a pinch hitter tonight. It says somewhere, I don't know if it's in the program or somewhere, it's supposed to be Pastor Leininger. But I showed up, so I'm pinch hitting. So, Sarah said it well. I'm just going to add a little bit to that. Martin Luther talked about the importance of music. In fact, he said that next to theology, it is the most important field of study. And so these students are doing something that is, in a way, doubly important. And it's something that Luther spent a lot of his time, you know, besides, you know, translating the Bible and writing, I don't know, shelves and shelves worth of theology, he wrote sacred music. And so to take music, which is so mysterious, why is it so powerful for us? We don't know exactly, but it is, universally so. Music moves people. Even people who say, I'm not really music people, probe long enough and they'll talk about, well, yeah, except if it's this kind of music, then that moves me, right? It moves us, and we don't know exactly why. I believe that's God. And to bring the word, the sacred word, together with that is, it's something profound, and we can't quite put words to it. Next to the sacrament itself, it might be the most profound experience, hearing the word in music. So that's an art that is going away in the modern world. I don't believe it will ever fully go away, because the church will remain, but it is rarer and rarer. Not sure that's a word, but I've used it twice now. And so we need to keep it alive. We need to keep it alive and bring it to people like yourselves and to people all over. People need to hear the word, and they need to hear the word set to music. That's in the inner city in Chicago, and that's true in Paso Robles, California, and everywhere else. And unfortunately, it doesn't pay well. Sacred music doesn't pay well. So that's why I'm here. The fun job of asking you to pay well. If what you can spare will be deeply appreciated. These students and their professors are excellent. Truly excellent, and that kind of excellence in something as moving and important as the Word of God set to music is rare and deserving. So, as generous as you can be, we will appreciate, And thank you. God bless.
Thanks, President Don. Again, I'm Jeff Leininger. I'm the university pastor here. We're so glad you could be with us. We're going to have a little break now, and we'll see you back in here in a few minutes. Thanks.
Thank you.
We began our year celebrating our theme of the year, which is Alive in Christ. And it's, I no longer live, Christ lives in me. And so this setting by John Rutter is a wonderful way to start our year. And we'll sing a few more pieces that actually illustrate that theme of the year in the context of mercy. But let's go to Felix Mendelssohn with Verleih uns Frieden, which is an ancient text. It's Da Pacem Gloriam. And so it's basically saying, in mercy, Lord, we're asking for mercy. And Martin Luther took this text and he translated it into German at a time in history when the Ottoman Empire was going through Europe. And one of his ideas, thinking was, we can pray. We need to pray the enemy away. And so mercy, we're still praying for mercy to this very day. And the music of Mendelssohn is still relevant too. And so we really think about the things in this world that need our prayers. And Mendelssohn really still speaks to the heart.
Thank you. Every year at our baccalaureate services, we have graduation commencement ceremonies in the fall and in the spring, and we have these service programs that we celebrate for our graduates. And one of our anthems that we sing is Christ is with Me, which you're about to hear. And so this is a compilation of our theme of the year, Alive in Christ. You can look at the text. It's a compilation of from the different epistles of Paul. But again, it's about, and being in the vineyard today, just seeing grafting and the horticulture that really escapes our modern age, and just seeing it firsthand and how beautiful it is, and God's relationship to us in that context is a very wonderful visual to understand how we are redeemed and how we are saved and how we are equipped to do what we can do. And so when we send our graduates, we're saying, here you've been given a lot of things in your experience undergraduate, now it's time to go and be fruitful. And so it's a very poignant piece, which originally got dedicated in memory of a small child who died in basically very young, almost an infant age. And so the importance of baptism is also brought about in this piece. I know you've been chomping at the bit to sing with us, and now it's your turn. Okay, page 6. If you've never experienced Teze, this is the evening that was well worth the trip. So the purpose of today's Teze is that it's meditative, it's prayerful, it's repetition, it's many good things just to center into a text and to think about your relationship with God. It's a very, very intimate type of approach, but we share it. So this Kyrie eleison. So we have this. It's a very simple text, and we'll introduce it. And I think Sarah, you're playing it, right? If I remember correctly, it's Rachel's going to be playing it. She'll introduce the tune, and then we'll join together. And if you can hum, you can listen, hopefully sing. All right, so we'll have several passes at it. So when it comes time, when you see the bottom of the page, which says last time, here's the business cue that I give. It's time to sing the last time. Instead of barking it out at you in the moment, it would just be more graceful, I think. It's been working on the tour, so I'm sticking with it. Thank you. So let's practice some text. Say, Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Very good. And then we've got some Latin. We've got Kyrie exaudinos. Domine. Now the same thing later on when we scan, look, see where measure 23 is. Christe exaudinos. Domine is the same text, but Christe. Christe exaudinos. Domine. What's so hard about that? So I think we're going to have a great time. So we'll meet you at the end, and I hope and pray that it will serve you well. you know, the tune or the hymn, Jesus Savior, pilot me. You're not going to hear that tune, but you're going to hear that text. A friend of mine was commissioning Jonathan Coors to write a new tune because he was counseling somebody who was suffering from cancer. And the person who was the receiving the care said, oh, I don't like that tune. And so, lo and behold, we now have a new hymn arrangement, and it's really, really evocative. And my friend is no longer, actually, I'll put it this way, my friend who commissioned it said, let's record a demo of it, at least the tune. And so Jonathan Coors said to me, could you sing the tune? I'm thinking, okay, this will be fun. And I loved it, it was really wonderful. I found that I knew the person who was suffering. And so I'm glad I didn't know before I sang the demo. I don't think I would have gotten through it when singing the tune. And my friend is at rest in the Lord now. And so we understand too that life is a mess. Life isn't fair. And even when things are well and kind of even keel, God tells us that he's always with us. Hope you enjoy Jesus Savior, Pilot Me.
Thank you.
Thank you for sharing this evening with us. What a joy. I know touring a choir and hosting a touring choir is no small undertaking. And just when we got off the bus here at Trinity and just welcomed, like, it was like coming home again. It was just really, really terrific. They have no idea. For me, it was. For them, like, hey, this is cool. It was just really, really wonderful. And from spoiling us, doting over us when we were just waiting around and being fed so well. it's just really a blessing. And so we thank you very, very much. Brian, Stacy, thank you for heading up a lot of the details for this. And for me, there's a fine line when you're a choir director in school and you get to know people. And there's something about music. There's a real closeness that you share. And to be a part of the cycle of life in church here for me is really wonderful. Like when Brian explained the story when he was this tall, I remember that time. It was my very first concert, my very first tour in October of 2000. And And so it's a real privilege for me to be a part of everyone's lives. They wonder, what are they going to do with their lives? And they get to be a high schooler. And then they go to college. And they're going to say, what do I want to be when I grow up? Wonder what we want to be when we grow up. You know, there's always that question we ask. And so it's just a real privilege to be here and just to see so many people that I know throughout the country and particularly here. So thank you very much, everyone here at Trinity. And we pray God's richest blessings to be with you, and his mercy is new every day. We also have a tradition. Müde bin ich, geh zur Ruhe, loosely translates to, I'm tired and want to go to bed. Thankfully, Brian and Stacy have a date night, so they can come on up and join us in the cappella. And so we're so looking forward to having them join with us once again.
I don't have any notes anymore. This is off the cuff, but praise God for what he's done through Concordia University Chicago and their cappella. We're so grateful that they're here. Have a great, wonderful night, and don't forget the free will offering donation is in the back. So, okay, God bless.